I'm John Batchelor, Steve Coll. His new book is Directorate S. That's a unit in the ISI, which is the secret police, the secret intelligence services of Pakistan, equivalent to our CIA, the CIA and America's secret wars in Afghanistan and Pakistan. Zalmay Khalilzad is an Afghanistan immigrant to America who becomes George Bush's ambassador. George Tenet leaves, Porter Goss comes in, but the number of continued CIA officers, most importantly, a man by the name of Dandrea. However, I want to concentrate right now on this period where there seemed to be quiet. When Khalilzad comes in, is his job there to restore balance, to empower the other warlords? I write down Fahim, Dostum, and Ismail Khan. Is he to knit together or to be Pashtun-centric?
Well, I think he's trying to do, he's trying to strengthen the government of Afghanistan. And through that, he's trying to strengthen Hamid Karzai. He has dinner in the palace with Hamid Karzai almost every night.
Right.
He's a wheeler dealer. He's an Afghan native, as you say. He's of mixed geographic and ethnic heritage, so I don't think he's seen as a partisan. But the whole idea that he was pursuing was to strengthen the institutions of the Afghan state at the expense of the warlords, who were still controlling, you know, large swaths of Afghanistan as independent fiefdoms.
Right.
And so he uses the U.S. military gradually to remove particularly troublesome warlords from their seats, sometimes by carrot, sometimes by stick. And he's working with Hamid Karzai to try to get a regular budget organized and to channel the international aid through ministries. And so it makes sense as a blueprint, but the resources are too small given the scale of the problem. The other thing Khalilzad did successfully was to carry out the first defection negotiations with Taliban leaders in exile. He basically had enough of an instinct as to who he could bring in from the cold that he managed to entice some Taliban leaders to come home from Pakistan and declare their support for the Karzai government. So it was overall, I think, the right direction, but it only lasted a couple of years, and he was sent off to Iraq to try to fix that problem.
Because Iraq is collapsing. Beginning with, I guess the summer of 03 is a warning, but by the summer of 04, we know that we've got an insurgency that is going to demand the Bush administration during an election in which, again, bin Laden is going to be the scare mask at Halloween.
Yes.
To drive the electorate. And Afghanistan is not part of the conversation. Steve, I report to you that I was doing this, and we talked about Iraq every night. We had no news peg whatsoever of Afghanistan. So it's a treat to go behind and see what was going on. Now, we have this search for bin Laden. Karzai's been emphasized now. Musharraf and Karzai are opposites here. Does Karzai want bin Laden? Does he want al-Qaeda solved? Is that an interest to him?
He wants ISI, Directorate S, to be pressured or basically disarmed because he fears that ISI has an interest in reviving the Taliban as a force in Afghanistan. And with the Taliban comes al-Qaeda. So I think he certainly supports the idea that it would be best for Afghanistan, as well as for the United States, if bin Laden were brought to justice. But his main focus, and it was really interesting to go back and excavate this because I was also kind of a beat reporter on the war as a magazine writer. I've interviewed Karzai a couple of times and seen him a lot at press conferences of one thing or another. And I was surprised when I went back and kind of got underneath the hood a little bit. Every time an American came to visit him, he said, the problem is in Pakistan. The problem is ISI. The problem is Directorate S. You have to do more to pressure them. You have to make it clear that they cannot play these games again. And the Americans would say, yes, we understand. But when they failed to act, we really confused him because he took for granted that we had the power to change this equation.
The search for bin Laden, we must mention it because it's a major subplot. It's not even a subplot. It's just sort of, it doesn't fit. It's like we have parallel worlds here. Alex Station. We've talked about Alex Station, which is the bin Laden hunt. And it's been going on for many years. And a man now enters the scene. Porter Goss is the unsuccessful, eventually unsuccessful DCI, and Michael Hayden's going to come in the second part of in 2005. But Michael D'Andrea, you described him as a vivid character, physically unattractive, imposing, ruthless towards someone who was not up to his standards, was in place a long time at the CIA. I think he spans the book. And you compare him to James Jesus Angleton, who's so famous. I mean, you put that in there, Steve. All of us who have read spy books spring on it. What does D'Andrea say about the hunt for bin Laden at this point? Is that a priority for the CIA? Does he do that exclusively of this Taliban a plot that's not been solved?
I think he's very focused on al-Qaeda. I think he believed that that's where the real danger to American security was located, and he certainly wanted to be more aggressive in hunting for bin Laden. He had a pretty able group down in Alex Station during a lot of these years, but you know, they just didn't have any evidence. They didn't know where he was. They assumed by 2004, 2005 that directionally, almost certainly, he was somewhere in Pakistan. They thought that ISI might know where he was, and that was one reason why they continued with this close embrace of ISI, even as ISI betrayed them, because they figured, how do you recruit an informant who knows where bin Laden is? Well, it's, you know, by flipping an ISI officer, the way intelligence services are often targeting their counterparts and getting them to cooperate
that,
or betray their
countries. Logical on their part.
Yeah, it makes sense. And so that actually deepened the kind of dysfunction of this alliance between CIA and ISI, because CIA was unwilling to leave it, thinking that this was a recruiting opportunity. No matter how badly ISI behaved, they thought, well, this may be the key to unlock the bin Laden hunt. So anyway, it took a while for them to even get the beginning of a clue as to where in Pakistan he might be.
The ISI is directed by Mahmoud Ahmad until the attack, 2001. He becomes a senior figure who has very ironic remarks in your book. Ehsan al-Haq is the director of the ISI until 2004, and then Ashfaq Kayani takes over. Kayani is a name we've heard a lot because he later becomes the chief of the army as well. So he comes from the ISI to take over the army. The presumption is that they must know something, and the director at S must know something. At the same time, we're following the theory that if we're going to find bin Laden, it's going to be the couriers he uses, his family, or the media he puts out, these statements he puts out.
Right.
All very good thinking.
Yes.
I agree.
Yes.
And it's going to take some time. So I could... At the time, if I'd known this, Steve, I would have reported to my audience, the CIA is doing the right thing. Do they now, many years later, think that that was the right path to follow? Or did they leave a stone unturned?
Well, no, I think they were correct in focusing on the couriers, because that's ultimately what solved the case.
Right.
You know, I know during these years they were thinking of everything they possibly could to model how they would solve the mystery. If, for example, they went back and they studied other successful hunts for fugitives, you know, Pablo Escobar, there were several who had been caught in Pakistan, and they tried to, you know, reverse engineer where the success had come from. Sometimes it was a mistake that the fugitive made buying some signature medicine that they needed, things like that that could be identified and monitored. I don't think we know the whole story of how bin Laden was identified and killed. I feel quite sure we don't. But I think that the basic idea that they knew that these were his vulnerabilities, especially the couriers, and that they eventually got a lead through the couriers that brought them to the end of the road, I think that's roughly correct. I'm very curious to know what it is that we're still missing, but that's the basic story.
Director at S is the book, The CIA and America's Secret War in Afghanistan and Pakistan. Steve Coll is the author. I'm John Batchelor.